Dear students, today we will discuss about the total amount of work done by isothermal reversible expansion of the ideal gas from volume V1 to V2. Hence, W max total amount of maximum work done W is equal to negative integration of V1 to V2 P dV. Here dV volume is taken because during isothermal reversible expansion very minute volume is taken, that's why dV is equal to very minute, dV is equal to minute volume. We know that PV is equal to, from ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT, hence P is equal to nRT upon V. Now W is equal to minus nRT integration of dV upon V. And in this way, W is equal to minus nRT log dash E V2 upon V1. On integration, W is equal to minus 2.303 RT log dash 10 V2 upon V1. V2 is final volume and V1 is initial volume. We know that from ideal gas equation, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Hence, V2 upon V1 is equal to P1 upon P2. Now, in this way, work done is equal to minus 2.303 RT log base 10 P1 upon P2. So, in this way, there are two formulas. One is equal to W is equal to minus 2.303 RT log base 10 V2 upon V1, and second is the W is equal to minus 2.303 RT log base 10 V1 upon V2. Now we will solve some numerical problem which is based on this formula. Question 1 is, calculate the maximum work for the isothermal reversible compression. Calculate the maximum work for the isothermal reversible compression of 2 moles of 2 moles of an ideal gas from 1 bar to 100 bar at 25 degrees Celsius. Value of R is given. R is equal to 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. So this one is the value of R. Now, if isothermal condition is taken, then work done is equal to negative, because from first law of thermodynamics, delta U is equal to Q plus W, and delta U is equal to 0, and Q plus W, and the Q is equal to minus W. In this way, W is equal to 2.303 RT log base 10 P1 upon P2, and point W is equal to 303 RT log less than P1 is, sorry, here P2 upon P1, because it is a reversible compression, that's why W is equal to P2 upon P1, log less than 100 upon 1, and it will be equal to 2.303, value of R is 8.314, T is 25 degrees Celsius, that's why in Kelvin it will be equal to 298 log less than 10 to the power 2. Now, W is equal to 2.303 into 8.314 into 298 and log less 10 to the power 2 is equal to 2 log 10 and log 10 is equal to 1, hence 2 into 1 is equal to 2. So, W is equal to 2.303 into 8.314, 298 into 2, and it will be equal to, finally it will be equal to 22823.39 joule. W is equal to this much joule. So, in this way we can calculate maximum work for the isothermal reversible compressor. Now, second question we will solve. Second question is, the enthalpy of formation of methane, question 2, the enthalpy of formation of methane, enthalpy of formation of methane, CH4 of methane at constant pressure, at constant pressure and 300 Kelvin, at constant pressure 300 Kelvin is -75.83 is -75.83 kilojoule. What will be the heat of formation? What will be the heat of formation at constant volume? At constant volume. R is given. R is equal to 8.3 joule per Kelvin per mole. Joule per Kelvin per mole. Now, the enthalpy of formation of methane at constant pressure and 300 Kelvin is this much. The enthalpy delta H is this much. Delta H is equal to -75.83 kilojoule. The equation for formation of methane is C solid plus twice H2 gas. This gives CH4 methane gas. With help of this equation, delta N is equal to 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. Now we know that delta H is equal to delta U. Plus nRT, delta H is equal to delta U, P into V, or P into delta V. So delta H is equal to delta U, delta nRT, where R is gas constant, N is change in number of, and T is the temperature. Now delta H is given, this one is the minus 75.83 kilojoule, delta U, we are going to calculate. Delta U plus minus 1, value of R is 8.3. Here R is 8.3 joule is given. And in kilojoule, it will be 10 to the power minus 3. And T is 300 Kelvin. 300 Kelvin. In this way, delta U is equal to delta U is equal to minus 75.83 minus 75.83 plus 2.49, and in this way delta U is equal to minus 73.34 kilojoule. The enthalpy of formation of CH4 at constant pressure will be equal to 73.34 kilo joule. So this one is the solution of question 2. Now we will solve next question, next numerical problem, which is based upon entropy. It's based upon entropy. This one is question number 3, numerical problem 3. Calculate the entropy of vaporization. Calculate the entropy of calculate the entropy of vaporization. Calculate the entropy of vaporization. Calculate the entropy of vaporization per mole of ethane. Boiling point of ethane is ethane is minus 88.6 degree Celsius, and latent heat of vaporization is and latent heat of vaporization is 15.674 किलो जूल पर मोल. हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द एंट्रोपी ऑफ वेपराइजेशन पर मोल ऑफ इथेन. बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ इथेन इज दिस मच, 88.6 डिग्री सेल्सियस, एंड लेटेंट हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन इज 15.67 किलो जूल पर मोल. एंट्रोपी ऑफ Vaporization is equal to entropy of vaporization is equal to delta S. Vaporization is equal to delta H upon delta T, and delta H is at present in kilojoule. So in joule it multiplied by 1000 joule mole inverse upon 273 minus 88.6 Kelvin, because if this temperature change into Kelvin, then it must be added by 273. So it will be 273 minus 88.6, and finally it will be equal to 85 joule per Kelvin per mole. 85 joule per Kelvin per mole. Delta S vaporization is equal to 85 joule per Kelvin per mole. So in this way we can solve solution of this question. Now write down next question. Next question: a balloon contains, next fourth question is, question four. A balloon contains 10 moles of a gas in a volume of, a balloon contains 10 mole of a gas in a 10 moles of a gas 10 mole of a gas in a volume of 5 liter a gas in a volume of 5 liter in a volume of 5 liter In a volume of 5 liter at 27 degree Celsius. Balloon burst so that gas expand against 1 atm pressure. Balloon burst so that gas expands against 1 atm pressure. 1 atm pressure. Calculate कैलकुलेट वर्क डन बाय द गैस, कैलकुलेट वर्क डन बाय द गैस। Now we need to first calculate volume. Volume V is equal to n RT by P. So here number of moles is given, number of moles is 10 and R is gas constant, value of R is given, that is 0.0821, and temperature is also given, 27 degree Celsius. So 27273, and it will be equal to 300 Kelvin. So into 300 Kelvin upon pressure is 1 atm. So pressure is equal to 1, and in this way finally volume will equal to 246.3 liter. Volume is this much, 246.3 liter. Now change in volume is equal to change in volume delta V is equal to 246.3 means 246.3 minus 5 liter, and it will be equal to 241.3 liter. Now this one is change in volume, hence work done W is equal to P into delta V, and P is 1 atmospheric, and delta V is 241.3, and it will be equal to 241.3 liter atm.